Have you ever wondered if life is not exactly what it's cracked up to be? Okay, let's take that thought a little further. Have you ever suffered from an identity crisis? Yes. One in which you were suspected that you're not a real person, but instead an extremely sophisticated computer simulation of a real person produced by an immensely more developed civilization than that which we take to be our own. Hey there everyone, I'm Himanshu Mehra and you are watching Techno Mania. Well, consider that everything that you have ever done or will do could simply be the product of a highly advanced computer code. Every relationship, every sentiment, every memory could have been granted by banks of supercomputers. Now that is fucked up. But actually, this was the terrifying theory first proposed by British philosopher Nick Bostrom. The shocking hypothesis was penned 4 years after Andrew and Lana Wachowski wrote and directed The Matrix, a film set in the dystopian future in which humans are subdued by the simulated reality. In his paper, Dr. Bostrom suggested a race of far evolved descendants could be behind our digital imprisonment. The future beings, humans or otherwise, could be using a virtual reality to stimulate a time in the past or recreate how their remote ancestors lived. Sounds crazy. Well, it turns out NASA thinks that Dr. Bostrom might be right. Rich Terrile, director of the Center for Evolutionary Computational and Automated Design at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, has spoken out about the digital stimulation. Right now, the fastest NASA supercomputers are cranking away at about double the speed of the human brain. The NASA scientist told Vice, "If you make a simple calculation using Moore's law, which roughly claims computers double in power every 2 years, you'll find that these supercomputers inside of a decade will have the ability to compute an entire human lifetime of 80 years, including every thought ever conceived during their lifetime, in a span of a month." In quantum mechanics, particles do not have a definite state unless they are being observed. Many theorists have spent a lot of time trying to figure out how you explain this. One explanation is that we're living within a simulation, seeing what we need to see when we need to see it. What I find inspiring is that even if we're living in a simulation or many orders of magnitude down in levels of simulation, somewhere along the line, something escaped the primordial ooze to become us and to result in simulation that made us. And that's cool. And if all this hypothesis wasn't enough, they even made a whole 30-minute documentary film just to teach the concepts of this theory. And if you want to watch it, then check it out here. I have a link in the description below and this movie is amazing. Well, going on further, the idea that our universe is a fiction generated by computer code solves a number of inconsistencies and mysteries about the cosmos. And to make it kinda not a brag, but Mr. Fermi proposed something here. The first is the Fermi paradox, proposed by physicist Enrico Fermi during 1960s, which highlights the contradiction between the apparent high probability of extraterrestrial civilizations within our ever-expanding universe and humanity's lack of contact with or lack of evidence for the alien colonies. "Where is everybody?" Mr. Fermi asked. "It could simply be that Earth and mankind is truly center of the universe." Another mystery explained by Dr. Bostrom's matrix-like theory is the role of dark matter. A US-based theoretical cosmologist, Michelle Turner, has called the hypothetical material the most profound mystery in all of the science. Dark matter is one of many hypothetical materials used to explain a number of anomalies in a standard model. The all-encompassing theory science has used to explain the particles and forces of nature for the last 50 years. The standard model of particle physics tells us that there are 17 fundamentals which makes up atomic matter. The Higgs boson, which was first theorized by scientists during the 1960s, is amongst those 17 fundamental particles. In summer of 2012, the same time the world will going to be end. Well, just an hypothesis, but it had never happened. Scientists at CERN, also known as CERN, observed what is now believed to be the elusive God particle. But the standard model is as yet unable to explain a number of baffling properties of the universe, including the fact that the universe is expanding at an ever-increasing speed. Dark matter is believed to be a web-like matter that binds visible matter together. If it exists, it would explain why galaxies spin at the speed they do, something which remains unexplained based only on what we can currently observe. The standard models does not yet hold an explanation for the force of gravity. The as yet unproven existence of dark matter could be explained by a virtual universe. Just like the human nature, not everybody is convinced about the matrix explanation. Professor Peter Millikan, who teaches philosophy and computer science at Oxford University, thinks the virtual reality explanation is flawed. Mr. Peter said, "The theory seems to be based on the assumptions that superminds could do things in much the same way as we do it to them." He said, "If you think that this world is a simulation, then why do they think the superminds who are outside the simulation would be constrained by the same sort of thoughts and methods that we are? They assume that the ultimate structure of a real world can't be a grid-like, and also that the superminds would have to implement a virtual world using grids. We can't conclude that a grid structure is evidence of a pretend reality just because our ways of implementing a pretend reality involves a grid." Okay, so far, after all this, a new question arises: that can we fully simulate the reality for a brain in the vat, also known as BIV? Now, for example, I clone myself and connect the clone's brain to a very sophisticated computer which simulates a part of the universe, for example the planet Earth. The simulation should be 100% authentic. In other words, my clone's character in the virtual reality should experience the same impact of fundamental instructions like gravity, some behavior of classical and quantum mechanics, same mathematical and logical laws, and so on. I see only two ways to do that. Either I should fully comprehend the workings of the universe to create a virtual universe with the exact arrangement, but I fear that it's not going to be possible to have a full knowledge of these fundamental workings. Or I should create a mechanism that somehow recreates the structure and behavior of our universe in the virtual reality. Considering the above, it is possible, in theory only, as a thought experiment, to create a full or a partial yet authentic copy of our universe in a virtual reality. And is it possible for dwellers of this virtual universe to create their own universe the same way recursively? I want to emphasize that I'm not asking if it's possible or practical to create a BIV, but I rather want to ask if it is possible to fool the BIV that the reality around it is real and make it possible for the BIV to deduce the unreality of its virtual universe. I don't know if we are living in a simulation or not, and I can't justify any testimony for it. All I can say that it's yet to be found and yet to be proved, though I think that we can't live in a simulated world. Or who will explain the double slit theorem? To be honest, that's so fucked up. If you don't know about the double slit experiment, go watch it on YouTube. I'm gonna link a video for it, and it's an amazing video that will explain the double slit theorem. Well, what are your thoughts about this? Do you think that we live in a simulation? If yes, then comment your thoughts about it and let me know. And if you think that this video is worthwhile, then hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe to my channel so that I can able to bring amazing videos like this for you. Till then, see you later.